I've become probably in the last 3 to 6 months more confident that we really are heading towards AI systems that are better than almost all humans at almost all tasks.
Far from outsider noise, this warning comes from someone with a front row seat to the AI arms race.
Anthropic co-founder, CEO, Dario Amodei.
A physicist and former OpenAI employee, he helped develop the first three versions of ChatGPT before becoming CEO of the AI startup Anthropic, bringing along six other former OpenAI team members. Throughout his career, he has operated at the forefront of artificial intelligence. Google was among the first to put their trust in him. Amazon so far bet over $8 billion on his vision. At the same time, he's also one of the leading voices calling for the responsible use of artificial intelligence, fully aware of its vast potential.
I worry about economics and the concentration of power. That's actually what I worry about more.
This is a story of ambition paired with conscience. How Dario's upbringing and early career led him to pioneering AI research at Google and OpenAI. How personal convictions drove him to build Claude and Anthropic's AI with his sister Daniela, and to champion safer AI development, even when it meant breaking away from OpenAI. In a world enthralled by AI's possibilities, Dario asks, can we win the AI race without losing our way? This is his story, a race to the top rather than to the bottom. Welcome to the entrepreneurial journey of Dario Amodei. Dario Amodei was born in 1983 and grew up in San Francisco, a city of innovation. But his world was far from Silicon Valley's shine. He and his younger sister, Daniela, were raised in a modest, working-class household shaped by resilience. Their father, Ricardo, was an Italian-American leather craftsman, a man who had arrived from Italy with little and built a life with his hands. Their mother, Elena, worked as a librarian, instilling in both children a love for knowledge and quiet determination. In the Amodei home, there wasn't much excess, but there was an abundance of values, hard work, education, and a quiet insistence on doing the right thing. But just as Dario and Daniela were stepping into adulthood, life threw them a brutal curve. Ricardo developed serious chronic health issues and passed away, a loss that shattered the family's center of gravity. Friends say it changed them. The Amodei siblings, already close, grew even more tightly bound by grief and purpose. Where others might have faltered, Dario and Daniela became laser-focused. They had seen up close how fragile life could be, and from that moment on, they seemed determined to make theirs count. Dario started high school at Lowell, one of San Francisco's most demanding public schools. There, he stood out. Not just for being smart, but for being curious. He didn't just want to solve equations, he wanted to understand where they came from. There, he studied how groups of neurons, the cells that make up our brains, communicate with each other. He wasn't just doing lab work, he was starting to ask a bigger question. How does intelligence work? After graduating, he earned his degree in physics at the University of Stanford, just outside his hometown. But Dario was still searching for answers, and he was determined to find them. So he moved across the country to Princeton for a PhD in biophysics. As soon as he finished his PhD, he returned to California, this time to Stanford's School of Medicine, where he was hired as a researcher, specifically studying how the brain learns. By now, he had moved from west to east and back again, chasing one big idea across the map. How the brain works? By this time, Dario started thinking beyond the human brain. The patterns he was seeing in neurons reminded him of something else, computer systems. And slowly, a new question began to take shape. What if we could recreate intelligence in machines? He didn't have the answer yet, but it was this idea, this unanswered question, that would push Dario into a new and rapidly changing world. Artificial intelligence. Around 2014, Dario made a pivotal jump from academia to the tech industry's emerging AI labs. At the time, AI wasn't on the verge of media and newspaper, but he got that there. He could work on something meaningful. He joined Baidu's Silicon Valley AI lab at a time when the Chinese tech giant was aggressively pushing AI research. At Baidu and later at Google Brain, where he worked in 2015, Dario cut his teeth on practical machine learning problems. This was the era when deep learning was taking off and companies were racing to train larger neural networks. Dario quickly earned a reputation as a brilliant researcher with an appetite for scale. He wasn't afraid to throw massive computing power at AI models to see what they could do. It was during these years that Dario first encountered what would later be called the scaling hypothesis.
I think among the first to recognize, they're called kind of, you know, scaling laws or the scaling hypothesis today. And the basic hypothesis is simple. It says that if you take more computation and more data to train AI systems with relatively simple algorithms, they get better at all kinds of cognitive tasks across the board.
At Google, and especially after he moved to OpenAI in 2016, Dario and colleagues began rigorously measuring how increasing the size of models led to startling gains in performance.
And we forecast that these trends would continue even when models cost $100 million, $1 billion, $10 billion to train.
Many experts were skeptical at first. Could it really be that simple scaling would bring AI to human-like abilities? Dario and a small group within OpenAI believed it. They saw a potential straight path to artificial general intelligence, if one could only keep scaling up. It was a contrarian bet, but time proved them right. By 2020, OpenAI's large language model GPT-3, which Dario helped oversee as vice president of research, astonished the world with its fluent writing and problem solving. Inside OpenAI, Dario played a key role in breakthroughs like GPT-2 and GPT-3, and the reinforcement learning techniques that would later make ChatGPT possible. Dario had spent years studying how complex systems, like the brain, could behave in unpredictable ways, even when the rules seemed clear. That understanding, shaped by his background in neuroscience and physics, made him naturally wary of oversimplifying intelligence, especially when applied to machines.
And these models are very unpredictable. They're inherently statistical systems. One thing I often say is we grow them more than we build them. They're like a child's brain developing.
In Dario's mind, the AI unpredictability was a source of risk. If AI behavior couldn't be fully anticipated, how could one prevent dangerous outcomes? By 2019, Dario, now 36, found himself at a personal crossroads. On one hand, the scaling approach he championed was propelling AI to new heights, fulfilling a scientific dream. On the other hand, he was increasingly uneasy about how fast things were moving and whether the leadership at OpenAI shared his urgency about safety. OpenAI had originally been founded with a mission of developing AI for the benefit of humanity, avoiding undue concentration of power. But as it evolved, taking on billions in investments and shifting toward a for-profit model, Dario and others felt the focus was tilting more toward competition and product deployment than cautious guardrails.
You know, OpenAI, a bit as you've alluded to, was founded with some claims about, you know, that they would do exactly this. But for a number of reasons, which I won't get into in detail, we didn't feel that the leadership there was taking these things seriously.
The tension within OpenAI's top ranks was mounting. Dario and his safety-conscious colleagues were watching the technology's capabilities explode, yet they worried that if mishandled, these AI systems could cause real harm, from misinformation to security threats. But then, this internal conflict at OpenAI reached the inevitable breaking point. If you haven't already, don't forget to leave a like below and subscribe to the channel. On Vision Economy, you'll always find new entrepreneurial stories in our Serial Entrepreneur series. In 2020, Dario, along with a handful of senior OpenAI researchers, including his sister Daniela, who by then had become OpenAI's vice president of safety and policy, made the dramatic decision to leave OpenAI and start anew.
There were seven of us total who left OpenAI together. We all co-founded Anthropic.
It was a bold move born of principle. The group of seven co-founders believed that OpenAI's leadership was not prioritizing the safe and transparent development of AI to the extent necessary. So they set out to create a company that would. In early 2021, Anthropic borned a new AI research startup with an unusual mandate. Anthropic was established as a public benefit corporation, legally bound to consider the benefits to society, not just profits. Dario took the helm as CEO, with Daniela as president. They were joined by five other brilliant co-founders, all fellow OpenAI alumni. This founding team's mix was striking. Dario was the scientist and visionary. Daniela brought expertise in policy, communications, and organizational leadership. And the others were top minds in AI research and engineering. Importantly, they shared a unifying belief that increasingly powerful AI must be developed carefully, with robust safety measures baked in from day one. Claude borned as the thoughtful alternative to ChatGPT. Claude indeed was built differently. It was instilled with a constitution of values. Rather than solely relying on humans to fine-tune every response, the OpenAI's method, Anthropic engineers had Claude follow a fixed set of principles derived from human rights and other ethical frameworks.
To train, you know, these models to make sure, hey, they're not sort of saying nasty things or they're not replicating bad inherent biases.
By 2022, Anthropic's small band of researchers had secretly developed its own large language model, a direct rival to OpenAI's GPT series. They named it Claude. This model was designed to be conversational like ChatGPT, but with Anthropic's safety DNA. It was trained not only to be useful, but to rigorously follow ethical principles and avoid harmful outputs. Meanwhile, investors didn't take long to show up. In late 2022, Google invested $300 million in Anthropic in exchange for a 10% stake. Less than 2 years after its founding, the company was already valued at $5 billion. But soon a defining moment came, a moment that well represents Dario's thoughtful view of the AI industry evolution. Anthropic's team faced a dilemma. Their first version of Claude was ready for release in mid-2022. Technically, they could have launched it to the public before OpenAI's ChatGPT took the world by storm. But Dario hesitated.
We actually delayed the release of that model roughly 6 months because this was such a new technology we weren't sure of the safety properties. We weren't sure we wanted to be the ones to kind of kick off a race.
This decision was practically unheard of in the breakneck-paced tech industry. Anthropic willingly held back a powerful product to conduct more safety testing, even as competitors forged ahead. Indeed, only a few months later in late 2022, OpenAI launched ChatGPT and seized a massive first-mover advantage in popularizing AI chatbots, securing popularity and headlines. Anthropic's deliberate caution cost it some spotlight and commercial opportunity. A sacrifice that illustrated just how serious the Amodeus were about getting it right. When Anthropic finally introduced Claude to select partners and the public in early 2023, the context was dramatically different. The world was now awake to AI's potential and potential pitfalls, thanks to ChatGPT's explosive debut. Claude didn't explode out of the gate like ChatGPT. There were no headlines calling it the fastest growing app in history. But quietly, Anthropic's AI began gaining ground. By end 2023, just months after its launch, Claude was already pulling in $100 million in annualized revenue. Not bad for a model that had been written off as late to the race. Meanwhile, OpenAI had just crossed the $1 billion revenue mark, dominating the market. But Claude wasn't trying to be the loudest. It was aiming to be the most trusted. And then something unexpected happened. In one striking episode, OpenAI's board of directors suddenly ousted CEO Sam Altman, triggering a crisis in the AI community. Amid the chaos, that board reportedly approached Dario Amodei to see if he would return to lead OpenAI, and even explore a merger of OpenAI with Anthropic. It was a surreal turn. The same organization Dario had left was now effectively asking him to come back and take charge. But Dario firmly declined both offers. Anthropic had its own culture and path, and Dario intended to see it through. Ultimately, Sam Altman was reinstated at OpenAI, and Anthropic stayed its course as a separate, principled contender in the AI landscape. With Dario Amodei firmly at the helm, Amazon chose to become a strategic partner to Anthropic. What began as an initial investment of $1.25 billion in 2023 quickly evolved. In early 2024, Amazon committed an additional $2.75 billion. And by November 2024, its total investment had reached $8 billion. These partnerships, first with Google, then with Amazon, gave Anthropic the firepower to train increasingly advanced models like Claude 2 and Claude Next, while keeping safety as the company's guiding principle. By 2025, Anthropic was reportedly generating substantial enterprise revenue, offering Claude's capabilities to Fortune 500 companies, and positioning it as a trusted AI assistant for professional use. As of March 2025, Claude had 18.9 million monthly active users, a modest number compared to ChatGPT's 400 million weekly active users, but one that reflects two radically different strategies. While OpenAI raced to capture the global consumer market, optimizing for virality and speed, Anthropic pursued a slower, steadier path, targeting enterprise environments where trust, compliance, and safety aren't just preferences. They're requirements set by boardrooms and regulators. And by July 2025, sources close to Anthropic suggested that new investment rounds were in motion, potentially valuing the company at a staggering $100 billion. Today, Dario Amodei stands as a leading figure in the global conversation about AI's future. In 2025, Time magazine named Dario and Daniela among the 100 most influential people in AI, recognizing not just their technical contributions, but their moral leadership. Anthropic, once a small rebel band, is now considered one of the big four lab players in advanced AI, often mentioned alongside OpenAI, Google DeepMind, and Meta. Governments seek Dario's input on AI strategy. Fellow researchers look to Anthropic's experiments in model governance as a blueprint. Dario has transformed himself from a lab-bound academic into the CEO of a $100 billion startup. Yet he's done so without abandoning the principles he and his sister set out with.
AI has these risks, and I'm worried about these risks. I get very angry when people call me a doomer. I got really angry when, you know, when someone's like, this guy's a doomer, he wants to slow things down. Some of these people who on Twitter, you know, cheer for acceleration, I don't think they have a humanistic sense of the benefit of the technology. Their brain's just full of adrenaline.
If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to the channel. We'll see you in the next episode of Serial Entrepreneurs. Until then, this is Vision Economy.